Namaste. Dear sisters and brothers of the world, today I am interested to tell you the story of India. India is a wonderful country with the second largest population. But the sad part is, the majority, they are very selfish, they are very greedy. They are dividing the society on the basis of caste, creed, race and religion. They are not responsible citizens of India. They are trying to create every opportunity to loot the country, to sell the nation, to destroy law and order in the country on various factors, caste, creed, race and religion. And selfish politician who has been ruling the country for decades, they have been always using the illiterate citizens of the country in their favor, and they have done very little for the growth of such communities. Congress has been founded in 1885 by H.O.U. Whole purpose was to give a vent to the aggressive attitude of the suppressed Indian, but it fought somehow under the banner of several great Indian leaders, including Subhas Chandra Bose and ultimately Gandhi, and got freedom on 15th August 1947. But the Congress remained in power because it was the hegemony of Nehru, and the Congress became bad to worse from time to time. Dynasty rule started, and it has come to the conclusion when there is no character, there is no morality, it is absolute chaos, there is no leadership traits and qualities, ended with Rahul and Priyanka. They are absolutely failed personality. So dear friends, what I mean to say, any political party, if it wants to serve India, it has to really see that the whole interest is in saving the nation, the interest of the nation, like food, shelter and clothes, water, electricity, houses, education, medical facilities, and giving the true knowledge to every citizen of India, teaching them patriotism, getting rid of all kind of devices, attitude, like somebody want Kazwe Hind, that is taught right from the beginning in their madrasas, the selfish and greedy people, they still feel that they can make the kingdom of Aurangzeb, Babur, Timurlen, Genghis Khan, all these invaders who really rule India. These evil thoughts should go away from the Muslim citizens of India. They should feel proud to be Indian. And there are so many greats like President Abdul Kalam, Governor Arif Muhammad Khan, my sister Subhi Khan. They are great majority of the Muslims who are far, far better than the Hindus. But the majority literate Muslims, they want to create some kind of Islamic Republic of India. And that is supported by leftist JNU, Yadavpur University, Jamia Millia Islamia, AMU. These are not illiterate from education and degrees point of view, but their mind is anti-national. That's why somebody called them Gaddar. And then the corrupt people blame those people who are patriotic. They are Subhas Chandra Bhagat Singh and Chandrasekhar Azad. They love the motherland. Anybody who talks against India, they are Gaddar, they are traitors. They are seditious attitude, personality. They have no place for India. That's what I want to tell you. This is small video. India is a vast nation with a lot of ancient reputation and respect. But modern India is highly polluted. judiciary, in legislation, in execution, because only a man with patriotic feeling of Subhas Chandra Bose, Yogi Adityanath, Yogi Narendra Modi, Yogi Virendra Yogi, they can only think about the sisters and brothers of India, daughters and sons of India, because we love every citizen of India. They are our own family member, but they put it. If the whole earth is our family, why not my sisters and brothers are my family members? Why not I should feel that they are just like us? As I care for myself, I care for every 1.3 billion citizen of India. But do they also care like that? Absolute bankruptcy of their patriotic feeling. They are totally ruined people with greed, anger, selfishness, and jealousy and cynical thoughts. They are all against Narendra Modi, because Narendra Modi thinks about India, he thinks about India. Here they are two largest community, Hindus and Muslims. They should learn to live together like just like own members of a family. Religion is nothing. Why they emphasize too much on religion? And if India is a shelter for all those people who were thrown about India, they want to come back, then if Divisive is a Hindu land, there should not be doubt about it. And there was the biggest mistake of Nehru, when India was divided on the basis of religion. Why Hindus remained in Pakistan? They should be brought back to India. And why Muslims though could not live with Hindus in peace? Why they were allowed to stay in India? This is the really bone of contention. Partition was by Jinnah. Direct action. Khilafat movement. Non-cooperation by Jinnah. And this was the hypocrisy of Jawaharlal, who really ruined India for all time to come. I don't mean that Hindus are great. There are a lot of black sheep in Hindus. Lalu Yadav divided the country in basis of caste, false reservation, win the votes of such kind of downtrodden, poverty-stricken Indians. But he never did anything for these poor people. He did everything for his own family. Chidambaram. And there are millions such kind of corrupt Indians who did everything for their family, whom they ensured that they will do a lot more for these kind of majority, lower caste people, what they call scheduled caste, scheduled tribes. And they make Mandal Commission, all selfishness. So any sister and brother from any community, remember, I am your mind. I love you. I don't believe in Hindu and Muslim. I only believe in wise citizens of India who love the motherland, who care for the motherland, who are not selfish,